actually partially correct. I will like definitely say that's correct because like fuck, they kill with their talents. Versus a falcon, they kill with their speed and their bite. So a falcon has a notched beak. Their beak has a little tiny scissor blade in it, basically. And that helps them cut their spinal cord, their prey spinal cord. So that way they're able to catch their food. So you're right. The falcon's feet, they're not as strong. Oh, you're very right. Yeah? We don't have a peregrine with us, and it's because they're actually not very common in the state, and we've never gotten one into rehab, and that's good. We've never gotten one into rehab, but that means we don't have one to show you guys because we don't have one that is not releasable. So right now we just have a kestrel for our falcon, but he's still really cool. He looks just like a peregrine, just tiny is all. He has every single feature of a peregrine. Pretty much just as fast as one, just his back speed is not as high as a peregrine. Peregrine is just the fastest, but falcons, in general, are all very fast. If you turn these birds around, you're going to only see it on one wing with Ariel, but her wings, they are much broader. They come out more. They are meant to catch the air and hold her up. Versus this bird, his wing feathers are more pointy. They're like scissors. Falconers call these birds long wings because they have such long primary feathers that help them fly. If this bird tries to fly in the sky and doesn't flap, so this is a falcon wing, you can see, very pointy. If this bird tries to fly and doesn't flap, they're going to fall because they can't glide on just this short amount of featherage. Versus with a red-tailed hawk, I mean, that's a lot of featherage to kind of rest on. It's going to like it's like a propeller. I don't know, you're gonna just stay afloat because of these large wings. Parachute, yeah, there you go. Their feathers are very glossy. You can see they kind of shine in the light. It's because they're really good at preening their feathers. Their feathers need to be drag-free, meaning if they have anything hanging from them, it's going to make them slow down. They literally cut through the air. They are meant to cut through the air. They are not meant to catch the air like some birds. So that's a couple differences. Yeah. And one last difference between a hawk and a falcon. Falcon, you could put her away. Yeah, that's fine. Unless, does anyone have any questions about Ariel? Do you have a question about Ariel? Yeah? I would have to say that this bird is stronger than this bird just because she's about 5 times the weight of this bird. So I would say that if this bird were trying to catch this bird and was able to, she would be able to eat him. But this falcon is much faster. His only predator called a Cooper's hawk, and a Cooper's hawk is not related to those two hawks we just saw. It's a different type of hawk. They only hunt songbirds, and that's his only predator. Now this bird, what makes it different, so you notice those black stripes on his face? So there's black stripes. Can you think of anybody else that has black stripes on their face? Yeah? Cheetah, right? Cheetahs have black stripes on their face. Who else? Yeah? What'd you say? Raccoons, right? So you see a lot of animals have that, and football players. So it's not just animals, it's also all sorts of people will put on eye black to help block that sun out. Those are like his sunglasses, so that when the sun isn't bothering his eye. He only has one eye. You see how he only has one eye? So you see his eye here. And then we'll turn around, and you see an eye here. Well, that's because falcons only have one eye. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Unfortunately, he got hit by a car and he lost his eye. So he doesn't have both of his eyes. That's why we have them. Because he did not see well enough to be released. If he turned them on, he would certainly, you know, not do so well at it. He had no depth perception at all. He is 6 years old, so he's one of our older birds. Kestrels can live up to 15 years in captivity. Not as long as something like a red-tailed hawk, which can live up to 30, so much longer. So the difference between a hawk and a falcon is that a falcon is a specialized type of hawk. So now you know. So you learned something. A girl looks a lot different than a boy in this species. This is the girl, the boy. The main difference is their wings. You can see he has blue all over his wings. That's like, oh yeah, you're stretching out for us. There you go.
So nice.
You can see how different Chip is compared to that female with all that red coloration. Now the reason that she has to be this color is because that's the color of her eggs. And she's going to be doing most of the incubation versus him. He doesn't care as much about camouflage. He's going to look a little bit different. That's why Chip is different color than his potential girlfriend that we always show him on program. So, any questions?
That's why he's
proud. Exactly. Why does he look so handsome for
how good I look.
So. You have a question? Yeah?
It does look a little bit like a chicken, but chickens are birds, and so are these birds. But these are birds of prey. Chickens don't have talons that can grab and like pump onto something. But you're right, they do look a little bit like a chicken. So does anybody have any questions about that? Yes, they do have red eyes. Yeah, we have an educational paper sock. We just didn't bring them today because he was already traumatized enough. Decided to just keep him, you know, hold.
Yeah, your question.
We only know because he came in as a juvenile this 6 years ago to another center.
This is
so
a Cooper shot.
That's this bird's main predator right there.
That's Archer.
So yeah, you're right, they do have red eyes.
But they not when they're juveniles.
These birds will often sit at your bird feeder and hunt your songbird. So if you have a hawk that constantly is sitting and waiting at your bird feeder. Yeah. Yeah, he clips one of his tail feathers. So in captivity, sometimes they'll break a feather. It doesn't hurt them. It's like cutting off a piece of your hair. It makes them not look as perfect. It typically molt once a year. So at this point, they molt every spring. So it's not spring. As long as he's able to fly, he doesn't break everything. We're happy. It's common for them to break one or two feathers, you know, especially if they have an eyesight injury, you know, that prevents them from seeing. He has an apiary where he's able to fly around. He has an enclosure. A lot of people think I keep these birds in this all the time. These are just their travel boxes, but we have large aviaries in our house that are able to, you know, they're able to stretch their legs, fly around, do natural movement. Yep, the hawk has an aviary. Yep, they're bigger, obviously. Smaller. Sometimes they'll have cage mates if you know the cage is large enough to support more than one bird. I find that the birds like to be housed with one other of their species when they're in captivity, so I feel like it's less lonely because even though they're not social in the wild, they do mate for life. They are used to being with other of their kind. They do raise their own young, so it's like natural for them to see at least one other of their own kind. So Chip lives alone. He's a bachelor. So. Any other questions? Yeah, but what would happen is if I were to hold him like by this right here and let him fly, he's going to be able to go up and out, but then he's going to reach the end of the string. And then he's going to go down. And then he's just going to hang upside down. This will all happen in like 3 seconds. And that makes him very stressed out. He prefers to just be perched on this love here, so that way he doesn't feel like he's upside down and scared. So that's a good observation, though. I could just do that. And maybe if he were to be slower than I am, I could help him fly like that, but he's very fast. So you guys want to meet an owl? Yeah? So we met all the different birds. Come here. Step back. There you go. Hey, hey. So we have 2 small owls, and we have 1 big owl, and we're going to start with this owl. Come here. See Ember here, and Ember is what's called an Eastern owl, and they're named after their call, so not all owls hoots. They actually do make all sorts of different noises. And we actually can play the sound of a screech owl. This is why they have their name screech owl. Yeah, that's what you know. Did everyone get to hear it? Yeah, hear that? So that was really loud.
And when you're in the woods at night, if you don't know what that is, you actually get very scared because you don't realize that it's a 4-inch little owl that really isn't going to do you any harm. That darkness does to the woods at night is scary, right? But he actually, he was flying along a roadside, and he got hit by a car. And that sounds tragic and so like, oh my goodness, that happened. But about 80% of our birds that we take in, that's the reason we're taking them. So they got hit by a car on another, whether it be 95, the Merritt Parkway. And they get hurt. And they get hurt pretty bad. Oftentimes they'll break bones of some sort. And if they're lucky, they won't break any bones. Have head trauma, their brain won't be able to work anymore, or even worse, lost an eye. So he's just like Chip, he does not have one of his eyes. He'll never be able to see well enough to be released because that eye got so ruptured. I did not think that this bird would be here. He was supposed to have another center up in Connecticut, and they said when he came into rehab, the eye was so swollen that they had no choice but to take it out, or else he would have just died. Brain not having enough room. So we're happy that he at least, you know, is able to live as an education bird. And we have two screech owls, but usually we bring both of them. Right now, the other screech owl we have is doing something called molting, where they drop new old feathers and they grow in new ones. And when a screech owl molts, it's actually particularly funny because they molt all at once certain areas of the body. So when Ash, the other screech owl, molted his entire face and he molted his entire chest. So right now he is just one big bird with no feathers. And he just looks so, so bad. And that's what screech owls look like when they molt. They molt one time a year. That's the one time a year we don't bring them out. Luckily, Ember decided to molt a different time than Ash did. So
I have a big comment. This is what Ash looks like when he actually has what he has to do.
So Ash is a screech owl as well. But you notice he's gray. He's actually gray. They come in two different colors, this species. They come in red, and they come in gray. This is obviously the red phase. And you might think, wow, a red bird is going to really stand out in the woods. But when they're 20 feet up in the tree, at sunset lighting, you will not see this bird. They are so well camouflaged. Their tufts here are not their ears. They're actually what's called their feather tufts. I sometimes call them by accident their ear tufts. Pretty cool. Owls are pretty bad because they can turn their head pretty far, turning about 3/4 of the way around. And that's like really far. We can only turn ours really so far. And it's because we have 7 bones in our neck on our vertebrae, obviously. And we have 7 in our neck region. This bird has 4 vertebrae. It makes it flexible enough to actually turn his head pretty much all the way around about. The reason they have to do this is it's hard to demonstrate with this bird. This bird, his eyes are fixed like headlights in a car. He cannot move them up, he cannot move them down. He has to just move his head to be able to have a full range of vision. And that's why they have to do that so much. Does anybody have any questions about him yet? Babies come out brown. And now
This is not the baby that they have. This is actually a different species.
Oh, is she tangled?
A little bit.
She's making her entrance.
There we go.
Styles, Bard, and Barn. Whoever named them wanted to make them sound as similar as possible, and it makes it really hard when people realize that it's not a barn owl. Her name is Willow, and we have her because, like, 80% of our birds, she actually did want to play a card. And if you notice, you're looking at two birds that have no feather tufts. So that first bird, the first owl you saw, had feather tufts.
Go ahead.
Wait. starts to think that owl is not people. Because if an owl thinks it's a person, it's becoming up to people. So people find a nest they live, and some people will be talented people that don't know what they're doing. That's a good thing. So we like to